Ready?
Hey, what's up, guys? Slushii here with Monster Gaming, and today I'm going to show you five things that I cannot live without. These are five things that I need on the road with me at all times, or else I can't survive. I need these things. These are things that I need. So I have two PlayStation controllers. I have a PS4 set up. Mortal Kombat tournaments happen daily on the bus, you know, UFC. Always got a Switch somewhere here where they play Mario Kart. Gets very bloody sometimes. So if you come follow me, this is where anybody who's sleeping, you know, it's usually pitch black in here. It's usually pretty quiet, but this is where everybody kind of just sleeps. And again, warning you guys now, it's the danger zone. Super, super messy. There's stuff kind of just everywhere. This is just how I live, basically. You know, I have my launch pad, which is pretty cool. Use it with my laptop to, you know, do some crazy stuff. I have my laptop. Can't live without this thing. I can't make music without this thing. I have my Bluetooth speaker. Bring this everywhere I go. I call it the lantern because you can kind of hold it like a lantern. Usually hang it off of stuff, and it's a party wherever you go. And lastly, oh yeah, on the floor is one of the most important things, my headphones. These are Audio-Technica M50Xs, and I've been using these probably since I lived in Jersey. Yeah, I've been using these for 4 or 5 years now, and I swear by them, and I mix all my stuff on these, so. Yeah, I was really into like Guitar Hero and like Dance Dance Revolution, which was kind of like where I got my first taste of like dance music and stuff like that. And it was kind of a big influence on my early music, was playing all of those rhythm-based games and stuff like that. And I mainly played on PS2, but I had a PC as well. I played this game called To the Moon, basically like an RPG type visual novel-esque game, but that's like one of my favorite games of all time just because of the music. Those titles have like really kind of influenced, like, I guess my music style. Well, I mean, for me, it was always like an outlet. Like if I ever had like a bad day at school, I would come home and just play Guitar Hero, and just for me that was like, you know, my version of like, oh, I'm on a stage and I'm like, I'm cool and I'm playing to this audience of like virtual people. Just something about it was super like therapeutic for me. A lot of the video game like 8-bit kind of sound design definitely like has a huge impact. But like if I were to have to pick a game specifically that's me, Dance Dance Revolution has influenced my music like the most. Apex Legends, Resident Evil, I've beaten it already. I want to go through, I played through Claire A, I want to play through Claire B. I beat Spider-Man the day it came out, but I still play it every now and then. I play UFC, Mortal Kombat. Haven't gotten around to getting 11 yet because downloading a game on the road, like the internet is just like trying to download anything on a tour bus. It's just a total toss up. Naruto Ninja Storm is like a big game on this bus. Like we'll just play it for hours and hours. Probably the star from Super Mario Brothers. Dude, imagine like it's the easy button. You just like, You pick up the star and you can just do anything. I'd be like autopilot like the whole time. I would get the star power, come back on the bus and sleep, and then rainbow fluorescent star me would be on stage DJing. I'd be sleeping. Come back on the bus, maybe either work on music or some nights I'll just go right to sleep. Something that we've been doing on the bus is, so we have like these like mood lights and we'll like turn it a color. We have like a killer sound system on the bus, so we'll just like connect my phone up to Bluetooth and just sit back and just vibe for just like an hour or two. And again, it's a nice contrast from, you know, having music blasting for hours and hours and hours, and then just being able to kind of release all of that pent up adrenaline and just kind of just chill. Like a lot of my friends are super surprised when, you know, they have this expectation of like how DJs live, and it's like when I come back and I'm just, you know, I listen to music after the show. Like I listen to like jazz and chill music after the show, or play video games or whatever. Not a partier at all.
I mean, I'm honestly a pretty lazy person, so like, you know, you could ask anybody. Like, I'm the guy that's always like, you know, you guys can go out, I'll just sit home and watch TV. I live a very like low-key personal life, which is like kind of the opposite of my stage life, which is like I play shows and I tour and everything. But then I go home and then I sleep for like a week straight and just do nothing but like watch TV and play video games and, you know, so it's a very interesting contrast.
I always think of it like Spider-Man. Like, you know, there's Peter Parker, then there's Spider-Man. So Spider-Man still has, you know, Peter Parker's voice, but it's just a more exaggerated version of just the guy. Like Slushii on stage is just a more exaggerated, yelly party version of the guy that doesn't like to party at all, basically, is what it comes down to, you know? I've always, and like ever since high school, like I've always had this thing where like I've, you know, I've never really been good at talking to people, but over the years I've kind of learned to kind of put on this persona of like the social butterfly guy, you know, and it's really kind of like been my way of kind of getting over my kind of social anxiety. It's like believing that I'm this guy that can talk to people. You know, somebody walks up to me and I act like, you know, I've known him for years, and it's because that's how I would like to, you know, kind of be treated if I was meeting somebody else for the first time. You know, my message to people is like, you can be a guy like me that played video games. I didn't do too well in school, but I had a passion for something, and I kind of had something that I wanted to say to everybody else, which is that, you know, you can do anything you want to do, no matter what anybody tells you, as long as you believe in what you're preaching, and it's a positive thing for the world. Like, you know, I have Asperger's and ADHD, which has been like a kind of like a crippling social thing. Like, you know, people say like, oh, you know, it's like a disability, but for me it was like, you know, I excelled in music because of it. I was horrible in every other school subject, but for music it was like I had tunnel vision. Like, I just picked up music so quickly. And there's a lot of people out there with ADHD, Asperger's, that kind of think of it as like a crippling disorder, when really it's like, you know, it's a superpower. I'm basically here to just tell people that like, it's okay to be weird. Like, I'm a weird guy, you know, I'm just normal weird guy, but like, it's totally, it's okay, you know? And you can still do what you want to do. I mean, it's like better to try and fail than to never try at all. I would have felt so, like I would have regretted so much had I not just tried to do this whole music thing, you know? I could have easily just been like, listened to everybody who was like, oh, it's unrealistic, you know, whatever. And I was just like, hey, I'll just try it and it might work out. And if it doesn't, at least I tried. And it ended up working out. So it's like, yeah, believe in your dreams.